So I've just opened Liberty, and basically what you can see is it's giving you different values and parameters that are relevant to the reflectance of a leaf. And we're just going to accept all these defaults at the moment and simply hit simulation and have a look at the spectral profiles that's generated. So we can have a look at this. This is the wavelength along the x-axis, and a reminder that this is the blue region, the green region, the red region, near infrared and mid infrared here. And this is the amount in percentage of either reflectance or transmittance of each individual profile. Now basically all we just want to have a look at is this red profile, so don't worry too much about the other ones. Now this is essentially saying this is the amount of reflected light for this particular leaf sample given this chlorophyll, cellulose, lignin, etc. content of that sample. We can easily change those values by clicking on parameters, and to start with, if you just change one at a time, then you can get an idea of what's actually happening based on those particular parameters. So I'll just change the chlorophyll down to 100. I'm going to specify an output file by clicking here and accepting that that's the file that I want to use there, and click OK. Now to view the difference in that profile, we'll hit simulation again. Now you see a slight amount of difference appear on the screen, but now we've lost the old profile, so it can be difficult to compare two different profiles. So the next thing that we do is to open it in Microsoft Excel. So if we go to open and select that file, click on delimited and then go to next, and make sure that it understands that it's space delimited, and then you'll see that it actually gives you different columns of data, and we'll finish up there. Now the quickest way to graph these results is first of all to delete this W. That's basically the wavelength column. We can come back to that later. These are the two reflectance profiles and the transmittance one. Now if we select all four of those columns and click on the charting wizard, go to XY scatter and this option here, and very quickly we can finish that up straight away, and there we see our profiles. Okay, and you can make various changes to the graphs to make it a little bit neater. But now if we go back to Liberty, the next change that we make in any of the chlorophyll, water, nitrogen, etc. content parameter values, they will go to that output file again, and we can again open that in Excel and use it to have a look at the graphs and how they compare with each other.